Hello, and welcome to the 741 channel. Today, I'm going to take a look at my dryer that's been squeaking over the last couple of days. The root of the problem here is actually a tensioner idler pulley that has a bad bushing. I've actually fixed this once before a few years ago by replacing the whole tensioner assembly. I'm probably going to have to do that again, but I don't have a tensioner assembly on me, and I need to dry some clothes. So what I'm going to try and do here is lubricate the existing one while I wait for the new one to come in. Before I get started with the repair, I just want to mention I'm not an appliance repair technician or an expert by any means. If you're going to attempt a job like this yourself, make sure that you talk to a professional before you get started. Now the first thing I'm going to do before I get started trying to take anything apart on the dryer is to unplug it. The next thing I need to do is remove two screws that are underneath my lint trap door. So next, I need to separate the top of the dryer from the door frame. So I'm going to open the door a bit, and then I'm going to use my spudger tool and push it into the seam where the top comes down to the door frame to release the spring clips that are holding the top on. So now I can pull the dryer away from the wall just a little bit, and the top should hinge up. Next, I need to remove the door assembly. There's two screws holding it to the sheet metal on the sides that are sort of inside the door frame. Let's take a look at that. I'm going to use a 5/16 socket to remove these screws. Over on this side of the machine, there's a screw here, but I also have to disconnect the door switch connector. I'm going to use a small flat-bladed screwdriver to kind of pry up on the locking tab and get it separated. Now that the connector is separated, I can remove this screw. The door assembly is now free of the machine, and I can just kind of lift up on it and pull it out of the way. Now that I have the door off, I'm going to focus my attention down here to the lower right corner of the machine where the motor assembly is located underneath the drum. Now the part that's the problem in doing all the squeaking is this idler pulley that's here. You may be able to see that the main belt is wrapped around the drum, goes around this pulley and around the motor pulley. So what I want to do is disengage this belt from the idler pulley. To do that, I'm just going to lift up on the idler arm so that the belt is loose, and then I'm going to reach in here and just work it off the pulley. So taking a closer look at the idler pulley, you can see here if I turn it, it's really hard to turn. I'm going to put force on that. It should spin as freely as the motor does here. Now that I have the pulley freed up, I'm actually going to try and remove it so I can put some actual grease in here. You may be able to see in the middle, there's sort of a triangular clip holding it on. So I'm just going to use my small screwdriver and try and pry up on that clip very gently so I don't break it and get it off of the center shaft. Now that the clip is free, the pulley should slide right off. So now I'll just clean the old grease and debris off of the center shaft and the pulley bushing. So now I'm going to put a small amount of grease on the pulley. Now this grease is actually for brake calipers on cars, but it ought to work just fine for this application. I want to put just a small amount on the center shaft too. So now I should be able to put everything back together. So now I'll bring the triangle clip back in and clip it over the center shaft so it locks into the groove at the end. So now I'm going to get the belt routed back into place. Now I apologize if my hands get in the way during this clip, but there's not a lot of room in here to work. So I'm going to wrap the belt around the tensioner pulley and then leave a loop for the motor over here. So now I'm going to lift up on the idler arm and then bring the belt around and loop it around the motor pulley. So now I can double check to make sure everything is working by just manually spinning the drum, and it looks like it is.
To reinstall the door assembly, I'm going to bring it back in place, and I'm going to make sure that the holes in the bottom of the sheet metal line up to these clips that are on either side of the frame. So now we'll swing the door assembly in place and make sure that this clip lines up to the hole in the frame. And now I can reinstall my screws. The next step is to reattach the connector. So next, I'm going to open the door, and then I'm going to grab the top and swing it gently back down into place. Once I'm sure everything lines up on the corners to the spring clips, I can push it back into place. And now I'll put the screws back in under the lint trap cover. So now I can plug the tryer back in and try it out. If you enjoyed this video or found it helpful, please give it a thumbs up. If you'd like to learn more about my channel, check the links in the description below. Thanks for watching.